everyone, welcome to my channel The Heart of the Art. First of all, I would like to thank all of you for supporting me, and today's video is about how to make homemade cold porcelain clay. I hope you will enjoy it, and now let's start the procedure. Take a microwave safe container, as we are doing this procedure in a microwave. So now I have taken half cup of cornstarch or corn flour. To this I will be adding half cup of Fevicol, that is 1:1 ratio. So now you can as well do this procedure on the stove. While cooking on the stove, try to use the non-stick pan so that it is easy for cooking as well as cleaning. So it is easy to clean all these vessels after the procedure. Just soak in water and it is easy to clean. Okay. Now I have taken half cup of Fevicol and I am just adding to it. Okay. To this mixture, now we will be adding baby oil or cooking oil, or else you can also add the hair oil. So right now I am using a hair oil which is jasmine flavored. So I have 1 tablespoon of oil I am adding. So I am using the jasmine flavored hair oil. Now to this I will be adding vinegar. If you have plain vinegar is also fine. Right now I have chili vinegar, so I am using it. So 1 tablespoon of vinegar. So 1 tablespoon of baby oil or hair oil and 1 tablespoon of vinegar. Now mix all the ingredients thoroughly so that you will have a thin layer of paste. So you can see the bottle. Right now I will be showing you Anmol Dabur jasmine flavored hair oil. You can also use cooking oil. So that is the chili vinegar I have, so I was using that. So now mix the ingredients well thoroughly so that you will have a uniform mixture. So almost it looks like an icing sugar. Now you can we are cooking in the microwave, so each and every microwave has a different power. Depending upon the power of your microwave, you can cook. So right now I will be cooking first 15 seconds, then I will take out and I will mix it again 20 seconds. I will repeat the same thing like in 3 intervals or 4 by increasing the seconds so that it will make lumps. So now I am just, based on my microwave power, I have just took 65 seconds to 70 to cook this mixture to make it a lump. Okay, so first I have cooked for 15 seconds, then I have stirred, then again after mixing again I kept for 25 seconds, then I took it out, again I have mixed it, so I have repeated till it became lump. So this is my second interval. Now in the third, my last was 20 seconds. So in total I have made this thing in 65 seconds. So it depends upon the power, some can go to 70, depends. So now my lump is formed. Now no more cooking. So just I wanted to, though it's mild hot, so I'll be kneading it at this stage. So for this I will be using a Nivea cream or a body lotion so that it will not stick the dough to my hands. So now I'll be applying a Nivea cream to my slab, kitchen slab, where I'll be kneading my dough. So applying the cream to the slab, I started kneading. So you can remove entire dough from the container as well as from the spoon so that you will not waste any dough. You can as well see that spoon as well as the container is clean, so you will not have much work in cleaning. Now start kneading. Before it dries up, you just start kneading and it will become soft. As you knead, the dough will become soft, the moisture is absorbed. Now thoroughly after kneading the dough, you will have a soft smooth clay. Now you just make a log and you can see just pull stretch the clay into two halves so that it easily stretches and you will get a teardrop shape. Okay, just start pulling. You can do 2-3 times to check your clay is stretchable and flexible in handling. So you'll enjoy this stage. During this stage you just roll and you can enjoy it. So you can feel that clay being soft and fluffy. So now let us try to preserve it or store in a polythene cover. You can apply little Vaseline inside the cover. So I am applying Nivea cream, as I have Nivea cream. Any body lotion is also fine. Just apply into the cover and you can just place the clay dough into the polythene cover. You can take a polythene cover or a Ziploc, whatever you are comfortable in having. So now my dough is ready and I'll be placing it in the polythene cover or a Ziploc. Now since the dough is little mildly hot, means it has some heat in it. So when you pack in the polythene cover, you are keeping it for a day, right, outside at the room temperature. Then you will get a tiny water droplets. So it is better to change the cover the next day. So now I am keeping my dough at the room temperature outside. So as it is hot now, mild heat is there inside it. So you will find next day you will find it small droplets of water. So better to change the cover and apply again Vaseline and just store it in a tight container. So it will be soft. See, now I have kept at the room temperature for a day. And the next day I have just opened it. So little bit I can find a wet, little moisture. I can see the moisture. So now you can start stretch the clay into two halves. See, now it's a very clear and very soft. You're getting exactly teardrop. So your clay is perfectly cooked and everything made. So now just I am using the same cover. I just reverse the cover and just applied the Vaseline and I'm using it. Now let us see something interesting out of this. So now let us make some simple flowers using this clay. We will see how it works and how easily we can mold this clay. So I just kneading my dough before I place it back into the polythene cover. Just I'm doing it, and you can store it in the room temperature in a container. So whenever you want, you can just take a little bit clay or enough clay for your craft work, and you can mold it as you want. So now already I have packed. Now we will be doing this interesting flower, a simple flower. So now I am taking a little bit of dough. Just for this activity you can have a rolling pin, otherwise you can have a small pencil or a sketch pen, whatever you have. Just make a ball, make a small ball of dough, and just try to spread a thin layer. Then you can use a plastic spoon and you can just take an impression of it. Then you will get a leaf it is. Okay, now start smoothening the edges. As when we are cutting, little bit of roughness is there. Just try to smoothen at the corners and then make a slight pinch at the tip, both the tips, just small pinch. Okay, you will, and then you can twist slowly in the down part. You can have a twist, smaller twist on the top, you little pinch and a small twist, and at the bottom a bigger twist. And now you will be making a small pollen where you can just roll on the platform, and so that you will have a head part little bigger than the normal thin, the bottom part. So now you will have a pollen effect. Just place it in the center of the leafy structure. Along with it, just make a twist. Just make a twist, and then just roll it. Just roll it. You got a very beautiful flower. Just twist and roll. Okay. when you are making a bunch, you can use a thin metal wire for the stem, then the leaves. After drying, once it gets dried, you can paint. So to show you, just I was using a small sketch pen. Now to color your clay dough, you can as well use acrylic paint one drop. Right now to show you, I'm using a sketch pen ink, little bit, 2-3 drops, and I'm just mixing it. So you can either use acrylic paint or whatever pigment you want, even the powder is also. When you are making dough itself, you can add the powder, colored powder, so that you will have a colored clay. I prefer doing white color, then you can add different colors. You will get the tempera powder, colored powder, and you can add acrylic paint, watercolor, whatever color pigment you want, you can add. The same thing using the colored clay, I am doing the same flower, same technique. Just only the color difference, how it looks with the colored clay. The pollen, I have taken the yellow color, and the leafy structure, I have taken the blue color. So in this way, you can mold your clays. And after drying also, it takes time. For a proper drying, it will take 1 to 2 days for proper drying. And it looks awesome, as it is very soft and the shiny. You will have a very shiny look. You can see the pictures as a reference pictures I have posted in this video. As it dries up, it has a very nice shiny effect, as we have used the baby oil as well as the Fevicol. And now the leaf I am doing. So you can arrange all this as a bouquet, and you can use the thin wires. Then you can use or otherwise you can you as well paint it with your desired colors. So this is a leaf. So I just rolled a clay, green clay, and just spreading. You can use the clay toolkit also. With a you will get the tools where you will have a ball at one end, big size, head size will be like a ball, where you can try to spread the clay. So just I wanted to show with a hand. So if you don't have a clay tool also, you can do. So I'm just doing the impressions on the leaf, the main vein and the midrib and the lateral veins. So in this way you can do. See, I have, you can see the rose flower where I have done. Thank you for watching.